Okay, well, I'm just getting down to the nitty gritty here. I've installed the metal guides, and you can see I used a slightly different, these are ARP bolts, and then I had to use some titanium washers and some flex washers. I was gonna use, what's it called? Loctite. I was going to use red or blue Loctite on that, but then I decided to just go ahead and use the flex washers. And then I took some measurements to make sure the depth was okay. But I wanted to show kind of how this all stacks up. So, and I wanted to provide a few tips on installation if you happen to be doing the timing chain. And this is the LCE Engineering dual row kit. Comes with, as I mentioned in one of my other videos, I didn't bother with the adjustable timing gear because I'm, you know, this is just my truck motor. One thing I did do, if you look carefully, is I took a file and then a reamer and I broke the casting right here to kind of smooth up those inner holes a little bit. Also, before I installed this, I ran it through the sonic cleaner with some gasoline to kind of get the, you know, the casting clean as much as I could. So as everybody knows, you know, when you install this, there's this link here is shiny on the chain and it goes with the dot. The dowel goes straight up and down at the 12 o'clock position. On the bottom down here, same deal, you've got a dot on the lower gear and the link goes there. Now if you take the chain and stretch it out, you'll see that there's the same number of links on both sides. So there's not a top or a bottom orientation of the links because there's an equal number of normal links on each side. So that's something to note. Here you can see same number, I use some different bolts. When you install this side, as LCE Engineering's videos note, you want to put this all the way out. When you just do a test install with the head, it seemed like, oh, I could go either way. But if you raise the head up 40 thousandths, which is what the thickness of the head gasket is, you'll see you really do need to have this guide kind of out that direction. Let me see if there's anything else. Oh, I guess you could probably see here, I'm getting ready to take the head back off, but I don't want my orientation to change, and I don't want, when I put the front cover on, I don't want the chain down there to slip off. So what I've done is I've just wire tied with nylon ties to hold this. And then this, when I pull it off will and take the head off, this will just kind of relax down in here. Definitely, if you're doing this job, watch the videos that LCE Engineering provides. And you know, they're very helpful. So, but as far as my motor goes, this is kind of where I'm at with everything. So I'm getting ready to, I think I've got everything done with the chain. Oh, another thing I wanted to mention, when I installed this lower gear, I put it in the oven for about 10 minutes at 175. And then when I took this little guy out, it was 160 degrees. And that allowed me to slide it on over the Woodruff key just using my fingers and some force. In the shop manual, they show a tool to drift it on. Myself, I like to heat gears up to get a little bit of clearance. And then when, excuse me, when they cool down, you get a little bit more of an interference fit. So anyways, real happy with how things are starting to come together. I'll provide another little update for anyone who's following along, but so far almost done here with the timing chain stuff. And then the next step will be the cover going on. I'll pull the head back off. I got to put the valve train stuff on, and then I'll be doing the head gasket and doing the torque there. And as I might have noted in one of my other videos, I'll be torquing the head gas, the head bolts down to 63 foot-pounds instead of the shop manual's 58. So that's 5 additional foot-pounds on the head bolts there. Oh, one thing I wanted to add here to the video, and I'll probably add a few more segments, but and previously I had mentioned, you know, hooking these wire ties on to kind of keep, you know, the bottom link from slipping out. And that actually didn't work. What I a couple things. One, I realized it'd probably be a good idea to put assembly lube on the gears and the chain and everything down there. And you can see I put the gear oil pump on there, and I did the little trick of putting it in the oven. So this is the assembly lube that I use here. Permatex, just ultra slick. You just get it off Amazon. What it is it's a startup assembly lube that's very sticky. It's kind of like a sticky, gooey oil, but it's really good for putting on your motor before you fire it up the first time. And it kind of helps prevent galling and scarring and all kinds of bad things that happen when you've had your motor dry, you know, oil and everything out of it, and you fire it up for the first time. So it gives the motor just a little bit of help until the oil pressure comes up for the first time and coats all the surfaces. But what I wanted to kind of comment on was, in order to get, you know, the link down here oriented correctly and hold it in place, what I resorted to doing was marking this link here with some paint, a paint marker. And that way I know when, you know, I've kind of got the tension on this, you know, this side straight, that if that is right at the top of the, you know, the timing chain guide, then I know I've still got my link hooked and wrapping up and around. And then what I did was I just kind of twisted this to keep tension on that side and set it down here. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the timing cover put on and leave this as is, put the timing cover on, and then I'll get the cylinder head slipped on real careful with the head gasket, and then I'll carefully kind of, you know, unwind that. Hopefully nothing slips there. And like I said, I can kind of confirm it by pulling everything and seeing that it's that way. So, okay, just a further little update here. I wanted to touch on something. So you can see I've put the gaskets on, and you might be able to see I drew a few little lines. So the reason I do that is because I use this product called gasket cinch, or gas cinch or something. I'll show it in a second here. And it's more or less contact cement, but it's pretty handy because you paint it on both sides. And then when it's contact cement, it kind of holds the gasket in place for you, and it creates a good seal, but yet you can get it back off. So you can kind of see kind of how it's holding this on, which helps a lot during assembly when it comes to building motors and things. Let me show you the kind of the product over here. So you can find a lot of information on it on the internet and stuff. Real good product, get it off Amazon. I just painted it out with a little paintbrush. I don't use their little dabber thingy, but I just painted it out with a little paintbrush real carefully. You can see I've already done this section here. And like I say, it's basically contact cement, so it cements the gasket in place. But yet, because it's contact cement like you used in school, you can kind of rub it off when, you know, if you have to disassemble stuff. So really great product. I'm getting ready to put the timing chain cover on. Along the base, I use RTV sealant. I use ultra black. You know, if you watch some of the other motor builder guys like Papadakis Racing, he seems to like, I don't want to speak for him, but in the videos I've seen, he seems like he uses the ultra gray. I've used that one. I personally don't care for it as much as ultra black. The ultra gray kind of, in my experience, doesn't stick as well. If you're pulling motors apart in between races, of course, then maybe that's better because it comes off pretty simple. If you're building a motor that you want it to go, you know, 250,000 miles, I use ultra black because it's a lot stronger. And if you want to see the difference, the way I settled on using ultra black is I did a test among all the sealants. So I had ultra black, ultra gray, and then there's another one, it's copper. It's like the same thing, but it's like a high temperature copper version of this. And what I did was I just, you know, put out three little dots of it on a paper plate, let it cure for 24 hours. And then I came back and I checked it to see like, well, how much does it stick to the paper plate? And what happens if I hit it with some gasoline or some oil or something? And Ultra Black is far and away the best one. This stuff is just, you know, unbelievable. I've used it for many, many different kind of things. I've used it to repair sunroofs. I used it to, I'll show you. I got a big can of it and I used it to seal my windshield around here. So that's actually just a bead of Ultra Black that I smoothed out with my finger. And when I bought the truck, it didn't have any of the weather stripping stuff. So I just, you know, had a big gap here and I ripped off kind of the weather stripping and threw it in the trash. And then I just took Ultra Black and I went around and ran my finger like you see. Yeah, works great. And then on the part that got on the windshield, I just rubbed it off my thumb and a little, like a little razor blade. Made a real nice seal. So anyways, just wanted to show kind of the gasket cinch routine there. Okay, well, we're moving right along here. I've got the front timing chain cover on. I do not have the oil pump in, so I have some temporary bolts just to set the gasket in there. I did put in the bottom bolt and I put the black RTV sealant on there. So everything went on real nice. You can see I bought some ARP stainless bolts here to hold for the main 10 millimeter bolts that hold everything in. Still got the chain in its proper position. I had shown this on before, but I decided to pull it back off and then put it on after the fact, since I needed some kind of, you know, up and down motion there to get everything aligned the way I wanted it. Like I say, I have a temporary bolt right there, and then I'll be putting the oil pump on later. I'm gonna put the head gasket on, but I wanted to show something first. In the video there, or one of the videos, I was showing how I had leveled this out. The gasket, actually, I don't know if you can see it, but the gasket kind of was sticking up. So what I did was I took a razor blade and I just very carefully on both sides cut that down so that wouldn't be interfering. And then put some RTV sealant here and here before I put the head gasket down. Also on this bolt here, you got to remember to put that in before you put the bolt into the end of the camshaft. Also, on the top of the bolt there, because there's oil, don't forget to put some RTV sealant there, and I also put it right here. Also, very important, do not forget that this bolt is not a blind hole. It actually goes back into, I believe, yeah, that's where oil is. So you have to seal those threads with RTV, Ultra Black is what I use for these, just to prevent oil from leaking out there on that particular bolt. So, and I believe the rest of them, I don't think they need RTV sealant, but I'll have to double check the manual there. So, all right, well, starting to look pretty good. Next up is head gasket. I'm gonna clean all the surfaces, go grab the Fel-Pro head gasket. As I mentioned in one of the other videos, I was originally contemplating using a copper head gasket on this motor, but if I wasn't selling my house and losing access to my garage, I'd probably do a little bit of testing with copper head gaskets on this motor. But for this truck, I'm just trying to get it to be reliable for the next few years. And so I don't really want to make it a test bed for testing, you know, copper head gaskets technology. But in one of the other videos, I had mentioned the LCE gaskets, and they have an integrated O-ring gasket that I kind of like. And if I build a 3 or a 2 RZ motor for this and turbocharge it, which is kind of my ultimate goal, that's probably the head gasket I will look into. For now, I'm just using the Fel-Pro Perma Torque head gasket, not the MLS one, but there's another one that is just it's more like a graphite head gasket, but it is a Perma Torque. It's actually From what I understand from talking to the guys at Fel-Pro, it's actually it's actually Kevlar to make it more durable, and it has a Teflon surface, I believe, between the gasket and the cylinder head to allow for the expansion coefficient differences between the cast iron and the aluminum of the cylinder head. So, in speaking with Fel-Pro, I was real impressed with that gasket. So that's the one I'm going to be running. So, anyways, should be getting the cylinder head on here pretty quick. This is the one I mentioned earlier in the video. It's the Fel-Pro Perma Torque. Part number is 26185PT for Perma Torque. Covers the Toyota 22RE 81 through 95. And I just picked it up in Napa. They also had it on Amazon, but when I got it from Amazon, it had been damaged in shipping, so the little edge had gotten banged up, so I ended up getting one locally. But that's the head gasket for anyone who's curious. Oh, something else I wanted to mention with regard to this front bolt that goes down kind of under where the distributor is and everything. I ended up making my own bolt and taking real careful measurements because you got to be careful for two things. One, the distributor shaft goes across here, so you got to check it and make sure that the gear is not hitting the top of whatever bolt you're using. As you can see, I took an old bolt off my Yamaha motorcycle, I think it is here, and I actually rounded over the edge to give clearance for this little gear that runs right above it. The other thing is it's extremely important to check the depth of this. When it goes through the head, what I actually did was I just, you know, I measured there very carefully with some calipers, and I actually test fit the timing cover to the head and ran the bolt in. And the reason is because actually on the bolt that came in the kit from LC Engineering, from what I could see, and this is the bolt off my Yamaha, so it's slightly different, but in the bolt that came in the kit, when you run it in, it actually bottomed out in the hole here and before it cinched down. And so if you put the cylinder head on and then you're just torquing away, you run the risk of stripping this out, I think, because I unless I'm looking at something incorrect, and I don't know where the bolt went to, but unless I'm looking at something incorrect, I think the bolt that is supplied in the LC Engineering kit is too long. Let me see here. They show all the different stuff here. The head to the cover, 55 millimeters. Here, let me grab my calipers real quick here. But like I say, that's definitely something to check because the bolt that I'm using here, try to do this one-handed if I can. The bolt that I'm using, if I remember correctly, I actually had to make it shorter so that it didn't bottom out. So the one I'm using here is more along the lines of 50 millimeters, 49, 50 millimeters, I guess you'd say, depending on how the washer stacks up there. But as I recall, about 51. As I recall, the bolt was about three millimeters too long, which, like I say, just double check, if you're putting a head on and you get the timing cover kit from LC Engineering, just double check this because, like I say, in my case, it sure seemed like I had about 2 or 3 millimeters too much depth, which would have raised hell when you torque it down into that aluminum front cover, this hole over here, this little guy right here. So just, that's something worth noting and worth double checking. So I wanted to mention that on the video in case that helps somebody avoid some sort of kind of strip threads in the front there. And interestingly enough, on the motor that was there in my truck, if you look, someone had stripped this out, because on my motor, whoever did the work previously, they had run a, instead of an 8mm bolt, they had run a 6mm bolt through and then captured it with a nut on the bottom, and it was at a weird angle. I was like, what in the heck did these other people do to this poor motor, you know? But now I think I kind of maybe understand what had happened was someone had a bolt here that was too long. So if you're doing the timing chain cover on your 22RE, definitely double check that before you start torquing things down. Okay, well, you'll have to excuse the furnace running in the background, but I just wanted to show the head gasket on. Put a little RTV sealant around here, and you can see the Fel-Pro gasket is in it. It lines up with the dowel pins real nice. And I cleaned all the surfaces and everything. Over here, this is some Motul oil, 5W30, which is mixed with this Lucas zinc product. And then I just pre-oiled this rocker arm assembly. And then I'm getting, I have some Torco on the cam lobes. I'm getting ready to put everything together. So I'll check back here in a minute. And then you can see I'm getting ready to install the head, and just ever so slight a coating of RTV up at the front, just to give a little additional sealing of the oil and the timing chain area around the head gasket. So, but like just ultra thin coats. Just a little added insurance. Okay, well, I just want to show where things are at. Excuse the furnace running in the background there. So I've got the head bolts in. And you can see I've numbered them 1, 2, 3, 4 in the order of torquing so that I can keep track of what I'm doing here. So far I've just taken a 17mm wrench and snug these down hand tight to settle in the valve train, because you have to do that when you put it all on there. It wants to sit up due to the valve springs. So I've settled it down hand tight, and then you can see the numbering that I've duplicated based on the shop manual. And then I'm just going to do 3 passes, 20 foot-pounds, 40 foot-pounds, and then I'm going to do 5 more than the shop manual. So then the final pass will be 63 foot-pounds. And then I'm just using this little snap-on wrench, which I've calibrated recently, so that should do it no problem. So almost have the head on, so that's pretty exciting, I think. Okay, let me torque these head bolts down, and then I'll update here in a second. Okay, well, cylinder's head is on. I've torqued the head bolts to 63 foot-pounds using my snap-on wrench, and then I'm gonna go back using this guy here, which is my gear wrench, digital, and just verify that they are all in fact set to 63 foot-pounds. So just that way I'll have double confirmation on the head bolts being torqued down. And then I took off the front bolt and torqued that down to 8 foot-pounds, so that's good to go. So everything went real smooth. I'm just going to verify the torque, and then should be good to go. Okay, well, that's a wrap on installing the cylinder head and the new head gasket. I used my digital torque wrench to verify everything was 63. So I think we're in business here. So that's got the new head gasket on. Head bolts are torqued. All I gotta do now is install this guy here, and then set the valve lash, then install the oil pump and the water pump, and should pretty much be on the road to reassembly. So okay, well, I'll wrap up this update here as far as in some of the tips on putting the cylinder head on. Be sure to stay tuned. If you're not subscribed to the channel, click the subscribe button there, because I have a video coming up that details the whole head surface scraping procedures that I went through to get this head and block and the front cover completely flat to within, I figure, half a thousandths, maybe 2/10,000ths of an inch, in order to help ensure that my head gasket would not blow down the road. So definitely stay tuned for that. I've got some editing to do on it, and I want to make it an interesting video for anyone who's got an interest in not only surface scraping, but also kind of, you know, showing what I did on the block to prepare for the new gasket. So, okay, well, thanks for watching this segment. Hope you enjoyed the update. As always, if you have any questions or comments, use the section below. Thanks for watching.